It is certainly possible. It's one reason he's unemployed. But Monday Morning Quarterback has a different take. It released an article ranking 15 backup quarterbacks better than Colin Kaepernick, the argument being that it is Kaepernick's skill level, in fact, that's holding him back. So we took those 15 names, and Lewis Riddick divided them into tiers, as you can see here. Jimmy Garoppolo at the top of Tier 1, Chase Daniel leading Tier 2, and Tier 3 anchored by Chad Henne. So we'll get to you, Lewis, and have you file in Colin Kaepernick on this board. But, Ryan, I'll just start with some general thoughts on what's here and how they relate to Kaepernick.
Oh, well, if you look at this group, I don't think that Tier 1 should be that crowded. I feel like Jimmy Garoppolo is kind of head and shoulders above, most of these guys. You look at Matt Moore and A.J. McCarron. Matt Moore did okay spelling for the Miami Dolphins last year. A.J. McCarron, we haven't got to see a whole lot of him. I know he's a hot name every time we talk about backup quarterbacks that could be starters. And so I think Tier 2, you add both of those guys to it, and maybe you don't put Colin Kaepernick on that tier with Jimmy Garoppolo, but I think he's much better than many names in Tier 2. And when you talk about the Matt Moores and A.J. McCarrons, he's definitely in the same conversation as those guys.
JoJo?
I mean, just taking the names that are on Tier 2, for me, you look at Colin Kaepernick, I think he belongs in that category. You can talk about statistically what he's done since Harbaugh has left, but just even from an experience standpoint, three of those guys just have 8 starts, okay? Colin Kaepernick has 58 in his career. Now, he's 28 and 30, but that's a lot of experience when compared to the names in that group. The other thing I look at is his playoff experience. No matter what you think about Colin Kaepernick, he still has been to the big games in the NFC Championship, in the Super Bowl, 4-2 in the playoffs right there. You look at two of those names, only 0-1 in the playoffs, that being Matt Moore and A.J. McCarron. Jimmy Garoppolo, no playoff experience. So for me, that and Colin Kaepernick's athleticism helped him to keep in Tier 1.
All right, so I'll tell you, Lewis ranks Kaepernick behind 3 current backups, Garoppolo, Matt Moore, and the aforementioned A.J. McCarron. So, Lewis, you have him right at the top of Tier 2, and in limited playing time, that trio I just mentioned that rank above him have performed as well or better than Kaepernick over the last 3 seasons. What's your thought process here?
Yeah, that kind of factored into why I put him there. Look, Jimmy Garoppolo, it's about future performance again. And we talked about this earlier in the show already. Look, Jimmy, his playing days, really his best football is all ahead of him. A.J. McCarron, his best football is all ahead of him. And that's part of what goes into making these kinds of decisions. Whether you're talking about starter, backup, whatever it is, that's what goes into this. Matt Moore is a guy who I've liked for a long time. I think he's the quintessential ideal number 2 quarterback as far as how his makeup, his football intelligence, and how he's able to play on short notice and keep an offense running at a pretty high level. As far as the rest of these guys here, look, if you look at Colin's play last year, context is very important when you look at Colin Kaepernick's play. His offensive line was abysmal. There were many times Colin couldn't even get set up, and he was just getting crushed. The wide receiving core, not very good last year. He had some good throws. He had some good situational football games last year. But he's not, I don't believe, if you were to really like project out this, if these guys had to play full 16 games and you gave A.J. McCarron and Jimmy Garoppolo the time to go ahead and play 16 games, I think they'd outperform Colin. But to put Colin behind and say all 15 of these guys are better than him and saying that Colin Kaepernick is not as good as Chad Henne, Landry Jones, Geno Smith, Drew Stanton, Derek Anderson, give me a break. I mean, that's ridiculous to me. Now, yeah, we all know what is surrounding Colin's unemployment right now. That's a whole different subject. Well, but we're sticking strictly to football. He deserves to be right there at the top of that list and deserves to be on an NFL roster.
Well, I'm going to hear thoughts from you, JoJo, and Ryan. But if that's the case, okay, so let's say that you agree or even close to agree with Lewis that he's at the top of Tier 2. You know, there have to be mitigating factors to why he's unemployed. I mean, there just has to be if you believe his skill set puts him here.
The only people who decide to make lists and put some of these quarterbacks ahead of him want to avoid the social conversation, want to avoid some of the mitigating factors in which you mentioned. And we all understand what surrounds Colin Kaepernick, but when we just talk about the play on the field, he does belong there. Lewis is correct that he should be at the top of Tier 2, and he should be on an NFL roster. There's definitely something else going on in making the decision to bring Colin Kaepernick to a team, and teams may not mention it all the time. Obviously, the New York Giants have. Mm-hmm. And so that is playing a part in why Colin Kaepernick doesn't have a job right now.
And real quick, one of the mitigating factors, too, is how does he make the starting quarterback that's on the roster feel? Because that's the situation that you saw kind of coming up with the Seattle Seahawks in terms of how would he make Russell Wilson feel? Could they compete together? But of those two names, it's also who excites the other players on the roster? And for me, that's